Hello, insiders. Wanted to go over some feedback that we've been getting on the YouTube Studio beta and provide a little bit more information about what we're doing with it. So if you go to the YouTube Studio beta, you know, on the left-hand side, there's a send feedback link. And I know when I use other people's products, I'm like, is anybody really gonna look at this? Well, the good news is we do. We actually read everyone, and then a team summarizes it, and that makes it to the product management team, and then we prioritize future improvements based partly on the feedback that we get. So thanks to everybody who's filled out that form. It does not go into some black hole. It actually is super important. And the team pulled together some common feedback we've been getting around YouTube analytics. And I wanted to kind of go over just a little bit of what we're doing about that feedback. So the first is we got a lot of feedback around like, hey, I can't see an exact date range. So in early May, we added some new options in the date picker, including current month, last year. The custom date picker where you can pick, you know, this specific day to that specific day is in development. I actually just tested an early version of it. It seemed to be working pretty good. So that's coming soon. We've been talking about, maybe another date range could be like since last upload. Not sure if you would find that useful. Let us know in the comments below. Another piece of feedback we've been getting about the YouTube Studio beta is, I love the way it looks. I need the real-time data. I need more kind of recent data. And that is available now in a new card in YouTube Analytics that is called the Latest Activity Card. And it actually auto updates every 10 seconds, you know, without refreshing. So there's like a little cool little beacon that kind of illuminates every 10 seconds to show you that new data is coming in. So check it out. Let us know what you think. We get a lot of feedback saying, hey, I can't see what my total sub count is. That is now going to be available in the YouTube Studio dashboard. So the moment you log in, if you've been enabled to get the dashboard, which is about to be rolled out in the next month or so to most people, you'll see on the top right corner your total number of subscribers. And then when you go into YouTube Analytics, we'll have other data. There is actually an open question about like, well, maybe should we show it in both places? So let us know what you think. Next feedback we've been getting is, hey, I want to be able to sort these tables in the YouTube Studio beta analytics section, you know, sort by CTR or sort by whatever the column headers are. And so as of quite recently, the new tables in YouTube Studio beta analytics are sortable. We're actually working on making those tables even more configurable so you can pick what columns you want. And certainly we are aware that more data around geography is of interest, so we're gonna be adding that very shortly. Another piece of feedback we've been getting is, hey, I really liked the old Studio Analytics where I could see a lot more data on one page. So we've done a bunch of things like to improve the YouTube Studio beta analytics section, like adding publish indicators. We added this key metrics visualization on the dashboard. We are adding this snapshot or video at a glance card. What would be interesting is if you are not seeing data that you want at all or you want it much more prominent, let us know specifically. Last item, speaking of groups and comparisons, we get a lot of feedback saying, hey, when is that coming? It is definitely a known issue. It's on our roadmap. We're working on it. If it's the number one thing that's bugging you about the Studio beta, let us know in the comments below. We can certainly try and rejigger prioritization. But that's a quick summary of feedback we've been getting about the new analytics in the Studio beta. And just wanted to say thanks again for everybody who's taken the time to submit it. I know you guys are all busy and you don't know where it's going and if it's gonna, you know, be any use. It totally is useful. It's totally valuable. It goes straight to our team and we really value it because this Studio beta, as you're probably noticing, we're making improvements, you know, every month for sure. And those improvements really are partly a reflection of the feedback we've been getting. So the more feedback we get, the more we can improve the product in a way that will be helpful to you. So keep that coming, and in the meantime, keep it real. Oh man, I gotta give you a little bonus. We'll see if anyone can know this movie scene. This is a short end screen filler. I'm gonna quote one of my favorite movies and see if anyone knows what movie this is from without Googling it. One ping. One ping only. Keep it real.